In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can make this form using only this code via a gem called Simple Form. Before I start, please remember to smash the subscribe button and give me a like. It helps me so much. Okay, let's jump into the video. The default form builder you get with Rails is really verbose. You have to write an awful lot, and I really hate it. Like, you've got to put the labels into like everything, which you should do. You should have labels. But it should be kind of done for you, in my opinion. You also have to kind of define what type of field you want. And if the underlying attribute is like just a string or a date time or a Boolean, it feels like that's something which can be figured out for you. So we're going to use Simple Form to do this for us. And it's a gem for Ruby on Rails where it makes it so you can pretty much generate forms and only have to say, okay, give me this input, and this like button, and it will just go off and do it. So let's jump into that. And I previously ran a scaffold. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just do reset --head, and that's just gonna reset our branch, my master branch, back to where it was before. We're gonna do bundle add simple form. And that's going to add the gem to our gem file. There we go. The file's now to do gst. There we go. We've modified our gem file. And we're now going to run the generator, or this one up here. And that's just going to add a installer and a few other little, and initializer even, and some configuration bits, which we'll go through later on. Finally, we're going to regenerate that scaffold from earlier. There we go. As you can see, this has now just changed. And that form, which was previously 47 lines of code, is now 18 to do quite easily. Six fields is that one there. Cool. That's pretty awesome. Let's have a look at what this looks like in the app. So we'll run the migrations. Okay, so it said I've got an undefined method. This is because I need to do Rails restart. And this is just to restart my Rails server, which is running over here. Okay, let's see how this goes. There we go. So this form is pretty nifty. If we go in here and have a look at the input type, it's seen this is an email and it's gone, okay, I want to set this up as type email. It's also made this drop down, it's gone and pulled all the associations, which we could potentially select, which is, that's pretty nifty. So let's mess around with this form a bit more. So something I'd like to do is, let's make one of the fields required. So if I do model pets, I'm gonna add a validation, so validates, let's do the name and presence true. That's just gonna go right. If it's true, that's good. If you look, it's just added a thing there. It says, okay, this is required. And if we look at the input, it has added, is this the string, the class required, which is quite cool. So that's close. It'd be nice if it did something in the browser though. So let's go look at the simple form configuration. Got this thing where we can tell browsers to use the HTML5 validation. Let's just turn that on and restart Rails quickly. So let's have a look what that does. Okay, so it's just kind of added the HTML5 required field or attribute. And yeah, it's just said, make sure you fill out this field without any JavaScript required. That's pretty cool. So the design of this form isn't like perfect either. Let's have a tweak of that. Let's go to the application HTML. I've got a link to Bootstrap's style in there, so that's looking all right. What we can do with simple form is we can do Rails generate simple form install --bootstrap And that's going to set up a bunch of stylings, which will be just perfect for Bootstrap. So let's have a look at that. We need to restart Rails first because we're changing the initializers. Okay, there we go. So that's quite cool. Getting there. Let's tweak the style of this form. Let's change it to be a inline form. Okay, that's quite cool. What about a horizontal form? Sweet, so we can quite easily change the entire design. One other thing we can do, we could change every form on the site. We can go to simple form underscore bootstrap, and then they've got the default wrapper here. So if I was just refresh that, let's change that. Horizontal form. Again, we're changing an initializer, so the first refresh won't kick in, but if we restart Rails, it'll update every form on the site. Come on, restart. There we go, perfect. So what is this file doing? So what it's actually doing is it's just saying, okay, in this type of form, add these particular classes. You can kind of go through and see kind of what it's doing is, again, just adding little classes in here and there, matching the Bootstrap docs. So you could potentially use the same kind of approach for using Tailwind CSS classes to potentially make your forms and have them be super nice. So I think that's quite powerful. It'd be really nice to have a little bit of spacing around the edges here because this has gone full width. So I've just gone to the application, the views layout slash application html.erb. It's going to do class equals container. Move that over and do that. That's nice. Let's jump in tweaking this form a little bit more. So it'd be really nice if this had a placeholder and a hint. So let's start with the placeholder. So I could do this, and that'll work. However, that's not the right way of doing it. The correct way is to do true. And so now I'll come up blank. However, if we were to tail the logs, so tail F log development, I have a little gem called ITN debug, which is saying, well, telling me every time the ITN is being looked up for a key. So let's kind of refresh the form and see what's going on there. It's a little bit too much to go through, so we'll do grep and then we'll just look for the name. Cool. G'day, so it's just returned this. And this is the key it's looking up, and so we can probably set that value via an ITN. Which is going to be easy long term if we ever going to translate the app or want more, let you know, keep copy out of the views. So let's go to locale in. And I'm literally just going to go, put that over one, find the dot, place that, and Mr. Fluff. Okay, so let's see what that looks like. So this is the ITN file. It's going to look up the key, EN, simple form, placeholders, pet, name. Sweet. Okay, so let's try and do the same with a hint. So let's do hint true. Okay, so there we go. It's just going to look up the hint as well. So let's add a hint in. So hints, what does it respond to? That's quite nice. Cool. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.